morning, dear students. Yeah, we are discussing about the chapter accounting for share capital. So in the previous two hours of classes, we studied about meaning of joint stock company, features of joint stock company, similarly types of companies, types of shares, equity share, preference share, regarding the how company will going to issue shares, that is about issue of prospectus, application, allotment, first call, final call, like that. We had just a brief discussion on this in the last two chapters. Okay. Today, we'll go for accounting treatment, how the shares company will going to issue. So, accounting treatment, company can issue the shares either at par or either at premium or either at discount. I repeat, a company, public limited company, can issue the shares either at par, either at premium, or either at discount. What is this at par? What is this at premium? What is this at discount? We'll have a small glance on this. Then you will be having a problem on this par and premium, but not in discount. Okay. What is this at par? For example, if a share price is 100 rupees, what you called as a face value, one share price, one unit price, face value, 100 rupees share is issued to public for 100, it is called as issue of shares at par. Issue of shares at par means face value will be equal to issue price. 100 rupees shares are issued to the public for 100. That is called issue of shares at par. I repeat, issue of shares at par means when the shares are issued to the public is equal to face value. At premium, 100 rupees is the face value. 100 rupees is the face value. But issued to the public 110. Sometime the company will have a lot of demand, so shareholder very rush to purchase the shares. In that case, company will take an advantage. Okay, face value is 100 rupee, but issued is 110. Okay, the difference amount 10 rupees is what we called as premium. The 10 rupee is a capital profit to the company. It is a capital profit to the company, 10 rupees. So that is what. So issue of shares at premium means when the shares are issued to the public more than the face value. When the shares are issued to the public more than the face value, it is what you called issue of shares at premium. Coming to this at discount, except Companies Act of 2013, except Companies Act of 2013 provision, Section 54, company cannot issue shares at a discount. Company cannot issue shares at discount. Okay, except 54, section number 54. Okay, so what is the discount? Actually, public limited company cannot issue shares at discount. Okay, 100 rupee face value, but issued to the public for 90. Issued to the public for 90. So when shares are issued to the public less than the face value is what you called as issue of shares at discount. Okay, so this is about accounting treatment for when shares are issued at par, when shares are issued at premium, when shares are issued at discount. Okay, now we'll go for the first one. When the shares are issued at par, as I already told you, for example, when share is 100 rupees, 100 rupees will not be collected in one installment. They are going to collect it some, maybe 3 installment or 4 installment, like that. For example, application, allotment, first call, second call or final call, like that. Okay. So now we'll go for the journal entry. What is the journal entry when the shares are issued at par at the time of application, allotment, first call, second call? Okay, so first we'll have a pro forma journal entry, then we'll start a problem on issue of shares at par. Okay, moving on to the next part, accounting treatment when shares are issued at par. As I already told you, okay, let me take an example. Face value of rupees 100. When share price is 100 rupees, that 100 rupees will not be collected by company in one installment. So as I already told you, it may be 3 installment or it may be 4 installment. Okay, first one, application. First installment is called application. Second installment called allotment. First call, third installment is called first call. Final call, or it may be a second call. Okay, some company they call it as second and final call. Some company they are going to call it as a final call. Okay, so 100 rupees will be split into, in my example, 4 installment. Okay, let me take for example, 120 rupees for application, 30 rupees for allotment, 30 rupees for first call, and 20 rupees for final call. Okay, so 20 plus 30, 50, 50 plus 30, 80, 80 plus 20, 100 rupees. Okay, so what company will do, in every installment, two journal entries we have. In every installment, two journal entry. First journal entry, when application money received. Journal entry number one, application money received. So you have to keep it in your mind. Okay. Application money received, that is journal entry number one. Journal entry number two, whatever application, share application money received, that should be transferred. That should be transferred to share capital account. That should be transferred to share capital account, whether it is equity share capital or preference share capital account. So journal entry number one, share application money received. Journal entry number two, share application money transferred to share capital account. Okay. So after application money received, okay, next company, next journal entry will be allotment money due. Journal entry number three, allotment money due. Allotment money due. Company will going to send a notice to the every shareholder saying that you have applied for so and so shares. So we are very happy to inform you that we are allotting so many shares, so you have to pay allotment money. Okay. And company send a due notice on allotment. At that time, money next will be allotment money received. Allotment money received. So that is journal entry number four. Okay, so journal entry number three, allotment money due, next allotment money received. Okay, next, coming to the next one, first call money due, number five, first call money due, next number six, first call money received, first call money received, like that. Okay, number, journal entry number seven, due, final call due, final call money received, that is journal entry number 8. Okay, so there are 4 installment, so in that 4 installment 8 journal entries will be having. I repeat, application money received, journal entry number 1, transfer to share capital account, allotment money due, allotment money received, first call due, first call money received, second, final call due, final call money received. Okay, so now we'll going to learn about what is the pro forma journal entry, how company will going to pass journal entries in the books of accounts. Then I'll going to take a small problem on when the shares are issued at par. Okay, moving on to the next part. So let us move on to the journal entry, pro forma journal entry, how journal entry the company will going to start. Number one, application, share application money received, journal entry number one, share application money received, share application money received, journal entry number one, bank account debit, when application money is received, bank account debited to share application account, bank account debited to share application account, being, yes, of course, every journal entry should be supported by narration, being share application money received. We are going to write how many shares and what is the share application money, we have to write. Okay, when I come to the problem, there you are able to understand what is the narration, how to write the narration. Okay, so when share application money received, journal entry number 1 bank account should be debited to share application account. Okay, so this is the journal entry number 1. If it is equity share, to equity share application account. If it is preference share, to preference share application account. Okay, so second journal entry, share application money transfer to share capital account. Application money transfer to share capital account. So this is the second journal entry. So second journal entry, share application account debit to share capital account. So this is the second journal entry when application money transferred to share capital account. For example, if it is equity share is there, equity share application account debited to equity share capital account. Preference share application account debited to preference share capital account if preference share is there. Okay, so second journal entry, application money transferred to share capital account. Share application account should be debited and to share capital account. So this is the journal entry number 2. Okay, journal entry number 3, when application money is received by company will going to give information to every shareholder saying that you have applied for so and so share, so we are very happy to allot the shares. When company will going to give information, that is notice about allotment, okay, so at that time company will going to pass allotment money due. So that is journal entry number 3, allotment money due. So journal entry will go like this: share allotment account debit to share capital account. So this is the journal entry number 3 when allotment money is due. Okay, next, after when company is sending a due notice, the shareholder has to pay money. Okay, when shareholder is paying money for a company, money is received on allotment. So journal entry number 4 is allotment money received. So journal entry will go like this: when allotment money is received, bank account debit to share allotment account. Bank account debited to equity share allotment account. Preference share to preference share allotment account. Okay, so that is journal entry number 3 and 4. Allotment money due, journal entry. Share allotment account debited to share capital account. Number 4, allotment money received, bank account debited to share allotment account. Okay, narrations, when I come to the problem, you are able to understand. Narration, I am not going to explain now. When I come to the problem, in detail, I am going to give you. Okay, so moving on to the next journal entry. Journal entry number 5. Let me take first call money due. So company is sending a notice about first call due. First call money due. Journal entry. Share first call account debited to share capital account. So this is the journal entry number 5, first call money due. Share first call account debited to share capital account. Okay, next, shareholder have to pay money to the company. When money is received, that is first call money received. First call money received. That is journal entry number 5. Sorry, journal entry number 6. First call money received. So when first call money is received on share, journal entry will go like this: bank account debited to share first call account. Bank account debited to share first call account. So this is journal entry number 6, when first call money received. Okay, so this is about journal entry number 6. 7, if it is second call, or it may be, okay, let me take as a final call. Final call due. Final call money due. So journal entry will go like this. Share final call account debit. Share final call account debit to share capital account. Share final call account debited to share capital account. So this is the journal entry number 7. Share final call money due. Okay. Last entry, journal entry number 8. Final call money received. Final call money received. Final call money received. So journal entry, when final call money received, bank account debited to share final call account. Bank account debited to share final call account. So this is the journal entry number 8. Okay. So four installment, totally 8 journal entries. I repeat again. Share application money received journal entry, bank account debited to share application account. Application money transferred to share capital account, second journal entry. Share application account debited to share capital account. Number 3, allotment money due. Share allotment account debited to share capital account. Next, allotment money received, journal entry number 4, allotment money received, bank account debited to share allotment account. First call money due, share first call account debited to share capital account. First call money received, bank account debited to share first call account. Final call money due, share final call account debited to share capital account. And final call money received, bank account debited to share final call account. Okay, so these are the 8 journal entries you have to remember when I come to the problem. Okay, with this I'll going to end up the today's session. Tomorrow we'll start a problem. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.